Kevin, I got the solution for you.
Do you think?
You will never let your plant die anymore. Let me show you. Come. Look at this. This greenhouse is completely automated. It has its own thermal regulation. It also has an automatic watering system. You can control it remotely thanks to its website. So, with the basic project, save your time and your plants.
So, after this beautiful head, let's make a technical review of the basilic project. The greenhouse is divided into two parts. On the left, we have the technical room where stand the electric stuff, and on the right, the plants room. The project is using an Arduino Uno and a Raspberry Pi 3. The Arduino controls the devices of the greenhouse, while the Raspberry allows us to have a user interface through a website. Our automated greenhouse has three main features. The first one is the regulation of the internal temperature. With this feature, we are able to maintain the temperature inside the plants rooms thanks to a heating lamp and a ventilation system. This temperature can be defined by the user. When the temperature increases and overtakes the set point, the lamp is shut down, then the fan is switched on, and a window is opened. However, when the temperature is below the set point, the fan stops and the window is closed. Then, the heating lamp is switched on. The second big feature of the Basilic project is the automatic watering system. Thanks to a soil moisture sensor, we are able to control the solenoid valve and the pump. The user can define humidity range to be sure that the plant has the perfect conditions. When the soil moisture level is below the low threshold, the pump and the valve allow the water to go through a pierced pipe. To stop the water flow, the soil moisture needs to reach the high threshold. For the automated greenhouse, we wanted that the user can remotely control the whole system. For this reason, we decided to design a website. To provide this feature, we had to use a Raspberry Pi as a SQL server with MySQL and as a web server with Apache. Our website is composed of two pages. The first one provides the different measurements and the state of the devices. Thanks to an external temperature sensor, we can have the external temperature. We decided to measure the luminosity with a photoresistor and to count the number of tats of each device. These measurements are here to provide additional information for future application. As you can see on the video, each information is updated every 7 seconds without reloading the web page. For example, we use an air dryer to increase the internal temperature and put a finger in front of the luminosity sensor. The second webpage is dedicated to the control and the parameterization of the system. The state of the device appears on this page to help the user to correctly control the greenhouse. And now let's take a look to an example of using. I want to open the window. Previously, I switched the window to manual mode, and then, thanks to the button, I'm able to open it. When the web page is updated, I can notice the change of the state. Here is another example. For this one, I want to change the set point for the regulation system. We can see that the actual set point is 60 degrees. When I validate the new value, we can notice that the set point changed. With the new set point, the fan starts and the lamp switched off. As you can see, the website can be improved in an aesthetic way. Some features can be added, like an historization of important measurements, such as temperature or the soil moisture. With your help, we could develop a version of the Basilic project that can be fit on larger greenhouse and it will cost under 100 euro. Think about it. With the Basilic project, save your time and your plants.